Episode of Extreme UTV, we're hitting some hills in Harlan, Kentucky with some of the best UTV Bounty Hill climbers in the country. This time we are at Harlan Campground in Harlan, Kentucky for race two of the 2017 Southern Rock Racing Series Bounty Hill Series. This is $50,000 on the line all across the year, and the biggest payouts being at the very finals of the series. All right, so today we've got five hills, and it works just like last time. Basically, all the drivers hit hill number one. If you climb it, you move on to hill two, and so on. If you don't climb it, you're out. They also, as a tiebreaker, count the number of backups, so you want to one-shot every one of the hills. And I climbed one hill last time, broke on hill two, so let's see how many I can climb today.
old transmission.
First 2017 turbo transmission I have seen do that. Or nated it. Axle hanging out. Turner's held up though.
Oh!
Bill, how many you got?
DC got.
And we're a team.
Team.
You got two so far.
Two? Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Got a strategy going.
Well, I'm just asking. So if I cross the line and time out, take my point and my my one attempt or whatever at it, nobody else can touch me, can they? Unless they climb it.
like IKT Diesel, SuperATV.com, and RSC.
Yeah. Right, man.
That's awesome.
You got a long list of sponsors to take care of him?
Nope.
Nope. Just you,
bro. Just me.
What'd you think about the hill?
I love the hill. I want buddy. With the love of the
hill. Wheels off my thing.
I did that.
DC Thompson. Laser Razor. I know you got a list.
Like, thanks Zach, man. Thanks Zach and Laser Razor.
What else you got on there that companies that take care of me?
Evolution and Coker with 3-piece performance. And about it.
Alright, let these guys get some pictures and videos.
Overall, that was a great day of muddy action trying to climb these hills. Hill number one was a cakewalk. Everyone made it up it. Hill number two was a little more difficult, but still fairly easy. And hill number three, that's when everybody started having an issue. I had a little bit of an issue towards the bottom on those logs. A lot of rain came down and they got slicked up real good by the time I ran. But then I one-shotted the real bad ledge and made it out the top, surprised myself even. A lot of guys had a lot of trouble with hill three and didn't move on to hill four. I moved on to hill four. I was second to run on it and got hung up on the skid plate. Didn't hit the hill hard enough or as hard as I should have and ended up hung up and rolled over not once but twice in the same spot, same issue. We will be putting a UHMW skid plate on this and getting rid of the aluminum one. I think that was a part of the issue. But then we moved on to hill five. It was fairly difficult the whole way. But if they got up to the basically straight up 4 or 5 foot tall wall, everybody tried it, but no one even got close to making it up. And in the end, it came down to number of backups. So they took the total number of backups for the entire day and decided the winner from that. So the guys with the Laser Razor, the four seater Razor Buggy, decided that they were going to pay attention to that. They only backed up their allotted number of times and then pulled away, and other guys attempted the hill as many times as they could until they were timed out. Smart on them, strategic-wise, but a lot of discrepancy with the drivers on whether or not we should have counted the fifth hill backups at all. But that's the rules according to SRRS, so they went with what they went with, and DC Thompson and the Laser Razor ended up first. And then that factory, basically Can-Am, came. This guy showed up last minute and wanted to come race with us, and everybody allowed him to come race. And then he came and showed up and showed out. He got second place, and then third place is Steve Mann in the live action RSC buggy. He did a good job today, climbed a lot of the hills, and much respect for that because they were some tough hills today. I'm pumped on how I finished. I climbed three hills today. I'm super happy with that. We'll see how I do on the next one. If you guys want to check out some older episodes of Extreme UTV, they're over here. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And let us know in the comments what you think about the rules. Do you think it should be changed? Do you think total number of backups for all the hills is the way it should be? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, guys, thanks for watching.